Hi everyone, welcome back. We want to continue talking about ethnic food.
Okay, take your first guess at what might be in my bag.
All right, well, it has something to do with our lesson, which is about food. So, is it food?
Yes, that's a good guess.
Come on, Kirby, give us another clue. I mean, food, it could be anything.
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's full of flavor, or it's flavorful.
Kirby, that doesn't help. That could be anything, too.
That's right. So I guess we'll keep thinking about it, and we'll get on with our lesson. We want to take a look at our first ethnic food. Join us now for Italian on line 14.
Italian. When you visit an Italian restaurant, order a pasta dish. The Italians have hundreds of ways of preparing this food. Pastas usually come with flavorful tomato or cream sauces, which give the dishes a powerful, rich flavor. Varied kinds of cheese also complement many Italian recipes. When ordering Italian food, you choose one main dish to eat yourself. You will, however, want to order an appetizer to share with everyone at the table. Bruschetta, a fresh bread and tomato dish, should not be missed.
Well, our writer tells us what we should do if we want Italian food. First of all, go to an Italian restaurant. That usually helps, right?
That's the first place to start.
That's right. If you want some good Italian food, go to an Italian restaurant and order a pasta dish. And when you order food, you just ask the waiter or the waitress, we might say the server, to bring you that food.
And what will happen is the chef will then make it for you. So you're actually by ordering, you're requesting that they would make a certain kind of food. And what you're going to request or ask them to make is pasta.
That's right. And pasta is pretty simple, isn't it? It's basically made of flour and water. But it comes in all shapes and sizes, right?
Yep.
And they cook it in many different ways. It says the Italians have hundreds of ways of preparing this type of food.
And it's very, very good. And these shapes and sizes are fun. Some of them are long and straight. Some of them are very curly. Some of them are thick and some of them are thin. And part of ordering Italian food, or part of the fun of ordering Italian food, is getting to choose the kind of pasta that you might want.
Right. And of course, the pasta, we might even just call it noodles. It's kind of like a noodle. And we usually get a sauce, some kind of a sauce, on top of this pasta. Pastas usually come with flavorful tomato or cream sauces.
Right, and when we do think of a sauce, we do think of something that's liquid. It can sometimes be thinner and sometimes thicker, but you do see that there's the flavorful tomato type of sauce or the creamy sauce or cream sauces.
And sometimes you'll hear people refer to either a red sauce or a white sauce, mm-hmm. And the red sauce is the tomato sauce. It has tomatoes that make up a lot of the sauce. And then the white sauce will be the cream sauce, because cream is what they use as a large ingredient in that sauce.
That's right. And they're flavorful, or full of flavor. They have something that makes them taste very good.
That's right. And these flavorful sauces give the dishes a powerful, rich flavor.
Now, powerful and rich are not things that I would sometimes think of using when you talk about food, but really what they both mean here is strong. When something's powerful, it can be strong. And when something has a rich flavor, it also has a very strong flavor.
That's right. Usually when we think of something that's rich, whether it's a dessert or a sauce like this, we usually think of creams and things like that, and the flavor is quite strong.
That's right. So we can see that varied kinds of cheeses also complement many Italian recipes. So this is just a little bit more so we can know about Italian dishes. You can find lots of cheese on them.
Now, notice this word. This is an interesting word. Earlier in the month, in our first lesson, we learned the word compliment spelled with an I. And that means to give somebody praise, right? Or recognition. But here, there is a different meaning. It's spelled a little differently, too. So be careful with this.
And this compliment, spelled with P-L-E rather than P-L-I, just means to make something seem better because of what you match it with or what it is combined with. So these cheeses, along with these sauces, bring out both of those ingredients' flavor, and it makes it very good.
So they complement each other well. Mm-hmm. You might even say that with your clothes. That jacket really complements those pants.
Mm-hmm, that's right. So this is a good idea. It's just to add something that makes it better than it would be maybe alone. And notice we see the word recipe. This is a little different than the word ingredients. Ingredients are what go in to make something. A recipe are all of the ingredients listed to make something. So it's a little different.
And also the other part that I like about a recipe is the cooking instructions. So it is a list of the ingredients, but then usually at the bottom of a recipe, or maybe at the top, they'll give you some cooking instructions, and that's helpful for me because I'm not a very good cook without a recipe.
You know what to put in first and what to put in last and how long to heat it up or those things.
As we move to the next page, it goes on to tell us what we should do if we order food in an Italian restaurant. When ordering Italian food, you can choose one main dish to eat yourself. So it's not the idea of ordering a lot of dishes and sharing them with a group, but you order one for yourself.
And this part of this Italian food, or the ethnic eating in Italy, can be quite different from other cultures in the way they eat. And you can see a nice picture of what maybe one main dish of Italian food would look like. It has the pasta in there we talked about, and it even has the sauce there as you look on top of page 25.
Okay, so you choose or you order one main dish to eat yourself. It just means you don't have to share with other people. You'll have that in front of you, and you will eat it.
But you may want to order what we call an appetizer, and we learned that word not too long ago. And basically, that's just a food that you eat before a meal that increases your appetite. Or maybe I would say helps you not to be so hungry before the big part comes, right? Or the main part comes.
Before your main dish comes. And an appetizer is also the first part of a large meal. Oftentimes you'll hear, well, would you like an appetizer? And sometimes on a menu you'll even see the appetizers and then the soups and then the salads and then the main dishes.
And one appetizer that should not be missed is bruschetta, a fresh bread and tomato dish. Now, the bread usually has kind of a garlic butter on it, and then there is tomatoes that are chopped up with onions and peppers and some other things, and then you put that on top of the bread and eat it.
Yes, how true, right? Well, that's Italian food, but we have some other great foods yet to look at, and we want to talk about those next time. Right now, it's time for us to review today's lesson. Join us.
Hi, 大家好，我是 Michelle。今天首先来看的是 ethnic 这个形容词。ethnic 在这里的意思是民族的，或是民族特有的，特别是指除了北美跟西欧以外的民族。例如 ethnic food 是指民族特有的食物，或者是 ethnic music 民族音乐。ethnic 还有另外一个意思就是种族的或人种的，例如 ethnic group 是指族群。如果你是华人，你的 ethnic group 就是 Chinese。如果是拉丁美裔的人，他的族群就是 Latin American。再来看的是 pasta 这个名词。pasta 是意大利文，它的意思就是指所有的意大利面食，种类非常的多。我们常见的有 macaroni 通心粉 ,macaroni, 或者是圆形的长条面叫做 spaghetti。S-P-A-G-H-E-T-T-I 还有千层面叫做 lasagna L-A-S-A-G-N-A 或者是长得像水饺的 ravioli R-A-V-I-O-L-I 接下来看的是 main dish 这个名词，意思就是在 appetizer 开胃菜之后上的主菜。Dish 是指已经烹调好的料理，例如 seafood dish 是指海鲜的料理，或者是 meat dish 是指肉类的料理。Dish 也指盘子，而且是指盛菜用的那种大盘子。如果是吃饭用的个人的碟子叫做 plate, P-L-A-T-E。意大利菜听起来真的好好吃，不晓得明天会叫什么好吃的呢？ I'll see you tomorrow.